China Coast Guard personnel on rubber boats surrounding Philippine Navy personnel, pointing pickaxes and weapons, puncturing holes on a Philippine inflatable boat, pointing strobe lights. Philippine Navy personnel attending to an injured sailor. The Philippines Armed Forces have released videos of the latest confrontation with China in the West Philippine Sea. A Philippine Navy sailor suffered a serious injury in what the military called intentional high-speed ramming by the Chinese Coast Guard during a resupply mission on the 17th of June. China also released pictures claiming its Coast Guard took regulatory measures against what it said were illegal intrusions. The Foreign Ministry claimed China did not take direct measures against Philippine personnel. The Philippine Foreign Ministry denounced China's illegal and aggressive actions. The Philippine military said the clash severely injured a Navy sailor and damaged Manila's vessels.
I want to emphasize that the Philippines, despite the advice of China, directly crossed the Chinese-Nansha Peninsula Ren Ai Jiao.
A Philippine military spokesperson said the sailor who received a medal for wounded personnel from the military chief lost a finger and was recovering in hospital. In what would be familiar to Indian viewers from the Galwan and other clashes, the Chinese, Philippine officials said, were carrying knives and spears. They looted firearms and deliberately punctured Philippine boats. They have no right or legal authority to hijack our operations and destroy Philippine vessels, Military Chief Romeo Bronner said in a briefing. They boarded our boats illegally. They got our equipment. They acted like pirates. China claims almost the entire South China Sea, which includes the second Thomas Shoal. That's where the Philippines maintains a rusting warship, BRP Sierra Madre. It beached the ship in 1999 to reinforce its sovereignty claims. A small crew of Marines is stationed on it. US Secretary of State Antony Blinken called Philippine Foreign Secretary Enrique Manalo to discuss China's actions in the South China Sea. Manila and Washington have called the latest clashes escalatory. Blinken emphasized China's actions undermine regional peace and stability and underscored the US ironclad commitments to the Philippines under the Mutual Defense Treaty, the State Department said. Relations between Manila and Beijing have soared under Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Manila has pivoted back to the US. In February 2023, Bongbong Marcos, as he's known, made the policy shift. That was days after he granted the US access to four more military bases in the Philippines, rekindling defense ties that had suffered under his predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte.